is how to map any ER diagram or ER diagram to relational schema. So we identified different types of entity sets, strong entity, weak entity. We identified what is relation set into it. Now we have to convert that ER diagram to relational model. How to do that? The first rule says that map each strong entity set. How you are going to map each strong entity set? Consider this particular diagram. Here, student is a strong entity set having roll number as the primary key, and there are other attributes are name, class, subject. So for mapping this strong entity set into the relational model, we need to create a separate table for it. Create separate table for each strong entity set. Another thing is, what should be the attributes of the table? All the attributes which are mentioned in this ER diagram will become the attributes of that table in the relational model. And then at last, we declare the primary key of this particular table as the roll number. So it is very simple to map each strong entity into the relational model. We have to create a student table having four attributes into it. That is roll number, name, class, and subject. And out of these four attributes, we'll consider roll number as the primary key of this strong entity set. Then the next rule is, second rule is mapping the relationship set. How to map a relationship set? So which is the relationship set here in this diagram, student? It is enrolled. Relationship sets are represented by diamonds in the ER diagram. So this diamond represents the relationship set that exists between student and course. So we need to create a separate table for this each relationship set. We need to create separate table in the database for each relationship set in the ER diagram by considering the primary keys of participating tables, participating entity sets, that is student and course. We need to include the primary keys of student and course, that is roll number and course ID respectively, into the table enrolled. And there are two more attributes of enrolled table, that is marks and joining dates. Marks and joining date. It means that when I create a table for enrolled relationship set, there are altogether four attributes. First attribute is roll number, second attribute is course ID, third attribute is mark, and fourth attribute is joining date. This is the second rule where we actually map our relationship set into the entity into the relational model. Third rule says that how to map the weak entity set. It means that we need to create a separate table for each weak entity set. First of all, you identify which is the weak entity here. It is dependent, right? So it is represented by double rectangle. It is the weak entity set. How you are going to create a table for weak entity set? You need to create a table for separate table for weak entity set by considering the primary key of the strong entity set. For the existence of this particular entity set, it always depends on the primary key of student table. So when I create dependent table, I must include the roll number and the attributes of its own. Primary key of the participating entity, strong entity, and the attributes of its own. Then the table will be complete. So create a table for weak entity set, add all its attributes to the table as a field, then add a primary key of the identifying entity sets, declare it as a foreign key inside the dependent table. Okay, so in the weak entity set, roll number would be a partial key, you can say, or you can say foreign key, which depends on the roll number column of student table. Then the next rule is about mapping the hierarchical entities or mapping specialization, generalization in the relational model. So here is the example of specialization. Person can be a student, person can be a teacher. It's a specialization, right? So student has role number, whereas teachers has employee ID. Person has name, age, and gender as the attributes. How do you going to map this specialization in the relational model? When you create it, create the tables in the relational model. We need to create separate table for high entities sets, as well as we need to create a separate table for lower level entity sets. The first rule is create tables for high level entity sets by considering all its attributes, name, age, and gender. For person, I'll consider the attribute as name, age, and gender. Then we need to create table for lower level entity sets. So we have two level lower level entity sets in this diagram, that is student and teacher. So when I create a table for student, I will include the primary key or the attributes, above attributes, into this lower level table also. So all these attributes of above table can be attributes of the lower level table. Roll number is the primary key for student table. Add primary keys of higher level entities in the table of lower level entities. Lower level tables, in lower level tables, we need to add all the attributes of the lower level entities. Declare the primary key of higher level entity and the primary key of lower level entity in the table. We need to also declare foreign key constants so that we should be able to join and fetch the data from this higher level entity and lower level entity sets. So this way we can create the tables for these specializations. So it means that when I create a table for specialization, I need to create three tables, that is person table, student table, and teacher table. And the next is generalization, creating a table for generalization. Generalization is the exact reverse process of specialization. In case of generalization, we need to only create table for student and teacher. In case of generalization, we never create a table for higher level entity set. We have to only create table for lower level entity set, that is student and teacher. So when you create a table for student, you will going to cover all the attributes of higher level entity set into the lower level entity set. So when if I use generalization to represent this diagram, I will create only two tables, that is student table having four attributes, that is roll number, name, age, and gender. Similarly, teacher also has four attributes, that is employee ID, name, age, and gender. I will not create a separate table, that is person, in case of generalization. But in case of specialization, I must create table for higher level entity set and lower level entity sets. That's what is the difference between representing this specialization and generalization in the relational model.